Oops.
Greetings, fellow makers. Welcome down to the shop and welcome to Prop 3D, your look into the world of 3D printing for prop and costume making. I'm Bill, and today I'm going to talk about why I'm not using vapor smoothing, that's acetone vapor smoothing, to smooth out all of the parts on the Boolean Gemini. I made a ton of progress on the build. Check it out. It looks so cool. In fact, all of the pieces are printed. Now, I just have a crap load of sanding to do to get this thing ready for assembly and paint, which prompted a lot of you guys to ask me, Bill, why not use that really cool acetone vapor smoothing technique that I've been seeing all over the internet? It's true, you can use acetone in a vapor form to sort of melt the outer layer of plastic and get rid of all of those pesky 3D printing lines. It seems like a quick and easy way to take care of the surface finish, and I'm not doing it. Why? Oh, it's crazy. Well, for starters, this is all PLA plastic, and this particular brand, this is the Matter Hackers Pro PLA. It doesn't melt with acetone. I tried, I printed out a little test piece, put the acetone vapor on there, and it had no effect. I do know that there are some PLAs that can be smoothed out with acetone. This is not one of them. Your results may vary. Now, I could have printed all of these pieces in ABS plastic. ABS is more susceptible to the acetone smoothing. I chose to print all of my parts in PLA because it tends to be easier to print with. But you guys want to know about the acetone vapor smoothing technique, so I printed out a couple of test pieces and gave it a try, specifically cold acetone vapor smoothing. I used magnets to hold some paper towels into an acetone safe plastic cup. Then I saturated those paper towels with acetone and placed the cup over the 3D printed ABS part. I left it there for about 45 minutes, and when I checked in on it, the towels were dry, but not much had changed on the model. So I repeated that process a couple of more times, and eventually I started to see a little bit more of a finish change on that piece. However, I didn't really see that glass smooth finish that I saw in a lot of the videos that I checked out when researching for this project. I predict that not all plastics and filaments are created equal, and it could be that this particular ABS plastic that I'm using just a little bit more hardy and doesn't melt as much with the ABS plastic and doesn't melt as much with the acetone. Now, I know what you're gonna say. Someone will point out, hey, Bill, you have to do the hot vapor method. You have to warm up the acetone and warm up the vapor to have more of an effect on the printed piece. But I'm not gonna do that, and I'll tell you why. I'm sure there is a safe way to do this, probably if you experiment, but acetone vapor is extremely flammable, and to heat it up, you're gonna need some sort of heating element. Those two combinations, flammable vapor, heating element, are a recipe for disaster. Of course, I tried it out myself to show you guys just how flammable it is, and it is frightening. The vapor from your acetone stays flammable for a very long time. And for that reason alone, I prefer to stick with just old-fashioned sandpaper. Okay, so the vapor smoothing didn't work out all that well for me. Does that mean I'll never use it again? No, I will continue to experiment. I'll probably try and get my hands on some different ABS plastic, do some more prints, and give it a try. But only when the situation demands it. For space guns like this guy and other hard-edged models, I'm probably still gonna stick with sandpaper. The main reason is that the vapor smoothing tends to round over all of the edges equally, and for stuff I want hard edges on, that just isn't ideal. What'll end up happening is you'll round over a bunch of hard edges that your 3D printer works so hard to achieve. You can see even just a little bit of the smoothing that I achieved with my tests completely obliterated the hard edges that were in my original model. Now, of course, if you're 3D printing something that's supposed to look a bit more organic, this technique would work out really, really well. I just can't recommend it for space guns. With sandpaper, I have complete control over the entire surface finish on my part. And that's the kind of control that I like to have when I'm going for a very specific finish. So I'll just be over here for the next couple of weeks sanding every single part on the Boolean Gemini until they are picture perfect. I won't subject you guys to all of that sanding, but you will get to see the end result in the next video when this guy's all ready for assembly and then eventually painting. And while I'm not excited about all that sanding, I am incredibly stoked to get on to the next phase of this project. All coming up, by the way, in the final three videos of this season of Prop 3D. Hey, thank you guys so much for checking out the videos. I hope you learned a little bit about the vapor smoothing and whether or not it's useful for you for your projects at home. If you guys are new to the channel, go ahead and give us a subscribe. We've got a bunch of prop and costume making videos coming out every single week. We've also got some older videos, including the previous videos in the series on our Boolean Gemini, all worth checking out if you haven't had a chance yet. Of course, if you're working on any cool 3D printed prop or costume making things, let me know in the comments down below. I'd love to check out what you're working on. Also, if you have any questions, give me a holler down there. I try and get back to absolutely everyone. Okay, it's time to warm up my sanding technique a little bit and get to work on the rest of these parts. I will see all of you guys in the next episode of Prop 3D.